Hi everyone, so welcome to my channel, and sorry I look so messy, but the funniest shit just happened to me, and since it's on Snapchat, I feel so bad because I have to tell it like right now and I don't have time or all the messages will erase, and I want to give you guys like the straight up story because this is hilarious, you guys are gonna die. So I'm chilling, right, you know, minding my own fucking business, and this dude messages me. We're gonna call him, like, Yapples or something. I don't fucking know. But he messages me, and he goes, "Hey, you should come over right now." And I was like, "No, bye." And he was like, "Wow, you're rude. I'm inviting you over, and you're just gonna say, no, you're a bitch." And I was like, "Why are you talking to me? Bye." I said, "Bye. No, bye. Like, get the fuck out of here." And he's like, "I was inviting you to my kickback tonight, and you're being really mean for no reason. Damn." And I'm like, "I'm just being honest, and you find it offensive. I'm so sorry if you find it offensive, right?" And he was like, "How are you being honest? You don't even know me. You met me once, because we hung out, like, one time, and during this time, he showed up drunk in a fucking suit at, like, 3 in the morning to my apartment, talking about, oh, I'm outside, let me hang out. Fine, because I feel really fucking shitty. It's 3 in the morning, and for some reason you decided to Uber over to my apartment building without my permission, but whatever, I'll hang out with you, right?" And then the whole time he tells me about how his mom would never accept me and how we can never actually, like, be together. So why the fuck are you messaging me? And then to sum it all up, that night, like, the first night we met, I was like, oh, when he was leaving, I was like, "I'm not going to call you back. I'm not going to talk to you again. Bye. Have fun." And he was like, "What? What?" And he messaged me. And he was like, "Oh, if you don't want to come, then fine. I don't care." I'm sorry for the random backstory, but back to the actual today story. "If you want to come, then fine. I don't care. You're just one of many people I invited to come to the open house. It's going to be lit, but your rude ass can stay home." And I was like, I am telling you, honestly, you already told me you're not looking for anything serious. And even when you were, I wouldn't be one of your first choices. You also said you would never let a girl like me meet your mom. And you really shouldn't do dates drunk, you know. Now, should you? And I was like, "I will happily stay at home, LOL. That's why I said no. Where are you lost?" And he's like, "Are you a bitch to every guy?" I would introduce you, because she wants me to marry a Jewish girl because he's Jewish. And y'all, I am not making this shit up. Like, this nigga is fucking insane thinking he needs to talk to me, okay? So he was like, "You're a bitch." And I was like, "I'm not being a bitch. I'm just telling you the truth. Like, we're not looking for the same things, and I don't want to hang out with you. So no and goodbye." Those are two honest words to how I'm feeling about you based off of what you've told me. So how am I being a bitch? Because I'm telling you the truth, and you can't handle the fucking truth. And so I was like, "You just can't handle the truth. There is a difference between being a bitch and telling the truth. You just can't handle it." And he's like, "You don't know shit about me. Stop trying to judge or assume things you don't know." And I'm like, "That's good for you. You can go now. Please stay the fuck away from me." I literally said, "Please stay the fuck away from me." And he's like, "What's your problem?" And I'm like, "Okay." And he's like, "You're not saying any truth. You're just saying a bunch of crap." I'm said, "LOL, okay. You just sound like a mean person. Either date me or I hate you." And I'm like, "Oh, that's so sad. That really sucks for you, doesn't it?" And he's like, "You must have no friends." And I'm like, "God, I'd hate to be you. I do have friends. I have a lot of friends. Like, what are you talking about?" And he's like, "Do you date all of them?" And I'm like, "Are you stupid?" And he's like, "Do you force them to hang out with you and all this stuff?" And I'm like, "I think you're stupid." He's like, "How are you just friends?" And I'm like, "You're just stupid and mad. I don't care about seeing you." Oh, I was like, "You're just stupid and you're mad that I don't care about seeing you and you're not, like, cute to me." And he's like, "I never said I was the cutest guy, but, I mean, you don't have to be like that." And I'm like, "I think it's time for you to exit my DMs, yabala. Thank you for coming." And he's like, "You're psycho, straight up." And I was like, please never return to my DMs in your life. And I'll be psycho if that's what'll make you leave me the fuck alone.
Call me a crazy ass bitch, because I will cut your fucking dick off if you talk to me again. Love you.
Like, bye now. Dick off. I'm not playing. Remember? Me forever. So, yeah.
I would show you guys the messages, but literally, it says his name. You know what? Fuck it. Okay? Fine. His name is Jashar. Fuck it. We all know, because I'm finna show you guys. Because literally, this is insane. Like, do you guys see this? Do you guys see this? Do you guys see this? Yeah. Yeah. So, you know I had to pull psycho bitch shit. Because, you know, when guys just refuse to leave you alone, you just gotta let a nigga know. Bitch, I will chop your fucking dick off if you don't get the fuck away from me. And I will feed it to your goddamn children. Huh. So, anyways, thank you for watching this random fuckboy story. Sorry I look a mess, and I am sorry, but literally, you guys love facts, and I like giving you guys facts, and I also like telling stories where nobody can say that something is not accurate because I just showed you guys the proof. So, you ever talk to Yashar, you guys already know what he's about. Bye!